I recently saw a movie where the main cast said something quite strange about success, but which I believe is true. He said, "Success is not a destination. Success is a journey." This isn't a fresh revelation. It's a notable truth amongst the best of the best, from Jack Ma, Mark Zuckerberg, Elon Musk, to Warren Buffett, Bill Gates, and others. You can be sure that right on their journey towards success, they each had their personal practices that have encouraged their success. And no matter what you think, those personal practices are almost always the same if we would just learn them. In today's video, I will be sharing with you 5 success secrets of millionaires. If you're new here, subscribe to our channel so you don't miss other interesting videos like this. 1. Do what you love. This is an age piece of advice, but still the best. Each day, I always can't wait to return to my work desk, and I hardly always feel like leaving my work desk. The reason is simple. I love what I do. Someone recently told me I work too hard, but I figure work stops being hard when you have found what you love doing and you do it. Chris Gardner wrote a best-selling book turned blockbuster starring Will Smith. But before his success, this entrepreneur philanthropist spent time homeless on the street of San Francisco with his 2-year-old son. Gardner eventually found success as a stockbroker at Dean Witter Reynolds and went on to start his own firm. He said, "Finding something you love to do so much you can't wait for the sun to rise to do it all over again." 2. Take responsibility for your life. Nobody can make you successful except you. You alone can shoulder the responsibility to achieve the kind of success you want. Jack Ma of Alibaba was called a crazy entrepreneur because he loved to sacrifice for the long haul. He started Alibaba, but the business didn't succeed until after many years. Although he was constantly encouraged to give up, he saw something bigger ahead and chose not to. Author of How Rich People Think and Self-Made Millionaire Steve Seibold said, "You're not going to be discouraged, saved, or made rich by an outside force. If you want a lot of money, build your own ship. No one is coming to the rescue." 3. Watch your spending. You can never become rich by buying everything you see. This is what millionaires and billionaires know so well. When Elon Musk sold his first company, Zip2, to a compact computer division in his late 20s, he could have spent the money on booze. Instead, he invested in X.com, now PayPal, and later sold the same company to eBay in October 2002. His wealth grew through investments, not through needless spending. Darrow Kirkpatrick offers financial advice to adults on their way to retirement. Mr. Kirkpatrick agrees that the secret to becoming a millionaire has more to do with spending than earnings. According to him, he puts priority over conservative spending. Carrie Kirkpatrick said, "If your income is higher than the $75,000 or so that researchers say is necessary to optimize happiness, then you probably don't need to spend all of it. Call that discipline. Call it a safety cushion. Call it conservation. But it's good for you and good for others." 4. Be willing to do dirty work. Dirty work does not mean killing people or something like that. It means you must be willing to do odd jobs on your way to becoming a millionaire. In my country, I can boldly say that thousands of people are poor because of their pride. They would be too ashamed to do what is demeaning, just to raise capital for their business. I advised a teenager to start to do my laundry and laundries of bachelors in our neighborhood, just to make some money for himself and learn the path of entrepreneurship. His mother told him not to do it because it would look like they were beggars who needed money. Well, this family was a dirt broke family, and I wondered why they should be ashamed. They were finally getting an opportunity to learn the ways of entrepreneurship. If you can't do ugly things to get rich, you will eventually do ugly things in the future, and by then, it may not be to get rich, but just to survive. Successful motivational speaker Les Brown didn't mind being a janitor for many months until he hit success as a radio DJ. Millionaire Steve Harvey slept in his car for a year or so and also lived broke for many years before he found success as a comedian. Anthony Robbins grew up in a poor home and did a cleaning job until he got the chance to save up to attend a Jim Rohn seminar where his life was transformed. If you can't do dirty things to succeed, you won't succeed. Wally Amos, the founder of the addictive bite-sized famous Amos cookies, said, "Realize that the only thing you can do by yourself is failing. If you're going to succeed, you'll need help and should be prepared to share the credit. Keep your ego in your pocket." 5. Know yourself. This is another aged piece of advice, but which is so valuable to success. Many young people struggle to succeed because they don't know themselves. Knowing yourself will save you the trouble of doing what other people are doing, because if you live your life doing what other people are doing, you will only be frustrating yourself into fitting into a capacity not suitable for you. For example, if you don't know yourself, your strengths and your weaknesses, you will keep forcing yourself to fit into a life not meant for you. Not everyone can become an entrepreneur. It is only in knowing yourself that you will discover what you are meant to be doing. I always knew I wasn't suited to start businesses, but I'm terrific at being a second person, the one who supports an idea and expands it. Most think it is weakness to admit they can't be entrepreneurs, but there are countless people who work their way to the top just by being employees. What matters is discovering who you are, finding your place and staying there. There is what your life is made for. That is exactly where your happiness lies. I don't feel uneasy going into my office each day, no, because I enjoy every bit of time I spend behind my laptop, crafting creative works for my clients and myself. Find who you are and what you love doing. This is where your happiness and fulfillment lie. Hayley Barner and Katia Beauchamp launched Birchbox in 2010 and grew it into a Fortune 500 company. According to Barner, spending all your energy focusing on the competition is a waste of time. Instead, focus on your company and what makes you unique. Hayley Barner said, "While comparisons are tempting, especially for competitive, ambitious people, it's always important to focus on your own special talents. That's how you can make a real impact. And it's the coordination of everyone's unique skills that can make magic happen." If this video inspired you, subscribe to our channel. We love you.